We have insane news about the upcoming OnePlus Z, and I'll be sharing the details right after this. If you knew him, stay up to date with the latest task. Please subscribe by the bow. You can also keep up on Facebook and Twitter by clicking the links in the description of the OnePlus. He is coming very soon after plenty more information to share with you guys today. Got more details of the launch date and the specs, more like photos of new color variants and use that may come under a completely different name. Before we get started though, please like the video if you're looking for the OnePlus Z. Let me know in the comments it is the OnePlus Z is waiting for, or if it's another phone altogether. Although it will cover the specs we've seen in a recent leak survey was posted. Leaks from OnePlus phone, which is of course expected to be the OnePlus Z. What it was much speculation before the survey does seem to confirm that we may be getting a conference of 5G enabled smartphone using the Snapdragon 765 CPU. We also have confirmation of a 90 screen 4300 mAh power battery with 30 watt fast charging, and finally a triple camera setup. Survey shows us we'll be getting a 64 megapixel primary sensor with a 16, and the two previous it was suspected that it could be a 48 megapixel primary camera. This new survey says 64. This could mean we get the 64 megapixel Sony IMX686 was rumored so early on. We also have confirmation of the 16 megapixel ultra wide, the 2 megapixel depth sensor. This unfortunately no way to authenticate this information though, and it does disagree with some of the leaks. We'll have to wait and see if this is true or not. We did also get another spec leak was uploaded for the OnePlus Z and does contradict the ones we just looked at. It was however swiftly deleted by the upload, or so means it is probably is fake or it was a mistake. We also have news of the OnePlus he is in becoming in blue, black and white. We also get a special limited edition color. We haven't seen what it is yet. Most interestingly there, we also have new to the OnePlus he may not be cold. OnePlus Z has been a bit of a roller coaster of names for this phone, as we originally thought it would be cool to the OnePlus Lite, then told the OnePlus Z, and now a new leak is pointing to the name of the OnePlus. Ignored the news come from Max J tweeted, "Let's play a game with the letter," and followed by three spaces is of course hinting at a new OnePlus name and many unsuspecting the OnePlus and old. We've also got another handsome photo of the OnePlus Z. It surfaced online, and again that we cannot verify its authenticity. It does look to be true and exactly what we're expecting. OnePlus schedule an online launch event for 2 July to load some of the budget TVs, and many assumed that the OnePlus he would also note alongside your information from Android Central. Disagree, so we're being told the OnePlus he is can have its own launch event, will of course be online only, and it's can be on 10 July when it comes to the upcoming smartphone that we've already got. One of the details of the OnePlus Z, including design specs, launch date and cost, will run through all of it now. As we covered, the OnePlus he has a full screen display. The ponchos of the camera top center, the display display is reportedly can be a 6.4-inch Supreme OLED display with a resolution of 2340 by 1080, which gives us 403 pixels per inch. We already know that this is also going to be at least a 90Hz display, considering OnePlus officially said that all future models would be. There are rumors saying that it could be 120Hz. These appear to be untrue. The display will of course be protected by Gorilla Glass. For this moment in time, we don't know what version this can be. No fingerprint scanner on the rear of the OnePlus Z. Pretty safe to assume that we can get the in-display fingerprint scanner when it comes to the selfie camera on the front there. Phone for those who want capable performance but also want to save a bit of money. We have design leaks very early on for the OnePlus Z. We've now had one of the hardware leak benchmarks as well as a handsome photo. We first take a look at the benchmark results. OnePlus he is a pit on the bench under the model number AC2003. In this benchmark we can see the OnePlus he has a respectable single call school of 612 and a multi-core school of 1955 if this benchmark is to be true with, and it also gives confirmation this can be a 12GB RAM variant of the OnePlus Z. It also shows us this can be powered by the Snapdragon 76 5G. Early leak suggested that the OnePlus he was can be powered by MediaTek's Time Entity 1000, but Mike Shea told us at the start of May that it would be the Snapdragon. Of course there's no way to verify these benchmarks, so it could still be fake. Is 12GB of RAM could be a little high for the mid-range device, but only time will tell. Next up with the leak from his top who have come across marketing, Renders for tempered glass screen protector on the OnePlus Z only to surrender shows the tempered glass. We also get a front view render. The OnePlus Z itself pretty much falls in line with everything we've seen so far and exactly what we're expecting, a pretty much full screen flat display with a poncho selfie camera top center. Next up, good handsome photo leak of the OnePlus Z, and again it was exactly in line with everything else we've seen so far. The photos leaked by a publication called True Tech received the photo from their private source. Like photo shows us that the OnePlus E has a flat screen and a pretty much full screen display, the poncho selfie camera top center. This is actually the first time OnePlus have ever delivered a top center poncho image. Is relatively low quality, so there isn't too much else to go on. We would go over the details of the OnePlus Z, including design specs we'll state and the cost. We'll run through it all now as we cover the OnePlus E has a full screen display with a poncho selfie camera top center. The display is reportedly can be a 6.4 inch supreme ruler display with a resolution of 2340 by 1080, which gives us 403 pixels per inch. We already know that this is also going to be at least a 90 Hz display, considering OnePlus officially said that for future models would be. There are rumors saying that it could be 120 Hz. These appear to be untrue. The display will of course be protected by Gorilla Glass. For this moment in time, we don't know what version this can be. No fingerprint scanner on the rear of the OnePlus Z. Pretty safe to assume that we can get the in-display fingerprint scanner. When it comes to the selfie camera on the front, there are many different rumors floating around, but many agree that this can be a 12 megapixel sensor. When it comes to the rear of the OnePlus Z, for the vertical camera alignment and digital camera setup with the LED flash, leaks were suggesting that it could be a triple camera setup. These also turned out to be false, as we covered earlier. At the lack of a physical fingerprint scanner on the back, it will be getting in display one. When it comes to the rear cameras, reports suggesting the primary cameras can be a 48 megapixel sensor, the second rate will be a 16 megapixel ultra wide, and of course we get the LED flash on the bottom. OnePlus, these cameras are going to support both optical and electronic image stabilization before the power button and a lot side on the right hand side of the OnePlus Z with the volume buttons on the left. The phone is of course powered by USB type Z, and there's no 3.5 no headphone jack. Many people early on reported the OnePlus Z can be powered by MediaTek Time Entity 1000. It's just not going to be the case. The OnePlus Z can be powered by the Snapdragon 76 5G. This muffins can come up with a choice of 128 or 256 storage and also 8 or 12 gigs of RAM. The use of the Snapdragon 76 5G also means this phone will have 5G support. For those unconcerned with 5G, it will of course support earlier LTE networks. Below the phone I mentioned, measuring 159.2 × 74 × 8.6 mm, and it will be powered by a 4000 mAh battery, support for 30 watt fast charging. When it comes to the pricing, is still very much in the moment, but it will of course have to be lower than the 8. Many were estimating the range can start around $450, but I think it could actually be lower. The $450 leak came out very early on. The market has changed a lot since that time, with the iPhone SE at $400 and the Pixel 4 expected to be $350, is creating some very fierce competition in the mid-range market with OnePlus One to compete head. That you have to do the same over. Although it's looking like a great phone that's offering a lot of the price, it is nice to see OnePlus going back to what they know best. For those of you that want to purchase one, though, is being launched next month in July. We don't know exactly what date yet, but Maxi has hinted that July has been fairly reliable when it comes to the OnePlus information. Unfortunately, the news I have a few guys today is also information comes in. I'll be sharing it straight away as always, though I'd like to know your force in the comments. Who others waiting for the OnePlus Z? If not, then what phone are you waiting for, and do you think it's can record the OnePlus Z or the OnePlus Note? But please subscribe, like the video or comment. Thanks for watching. See you on my next video. One, peace out.